What's going on, gardeners? It's Sunday, August 1st, and it is a steamy day here on the southeastern coast of North Carolina. Today, I'm going to show you all how to double your cucumber harvest by growing these two incredible cucumber varieties, and also give you a couple of production-boosting tips along the way.
If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing and hitting the bell to receive new video notifications, and check out our Amazon storefront and Spread Shop in the video description for a list of the gardening products I use and awesome custom designed apparel and other gear. Your support is greatly appreciated.
Cucumbers can be a challenging plant for many gardeners. They're vulnerable to pests, they're susceptible to diseases, and sometimes they just don't set a lot of fruit. Last year, I made a very detailed video on how you can increase the productivity of your cucumber plants, which I will link to above. I strongly recommend everyone give it a watch because it goes into great detail as to why so many gardeners struggle with cucumber production. For those of you that haven't seen the video, I will give you a brief recap on why so many gardeners struggle growing cucumbers. Cucumbers belong to a family of plants called cucurbits, which include plants like cucumbers, zucchini, squash, melons, pumpkins, and gourds. Cucurbits are self-fertile plants, which means you only have to grow one plant to produce fruit, and it doesn't require cross-pollination from another genetically unique plant. So, one cucumber plant is all that is required to grow cucumbers. However, there is a problem. Self-fertile plants like tomatoes and peppers have the male and female parts of the flower enclosed all within a single flower. The bloom itself contains both the male pollen-producing stamen and the female pollen-accepting pistil. Therefore, all that is required for plants like these to be pollinated is wind. The wind just has to come and shake the flowers, and the pollen will mix around, get inside the female parts, all enclosed within that one flower, and you will get fruit set. That's all it takes to pollinate a tomato or a pepper. Cucurbits, on the other hand, are very different and more challenging. That's because cucurbits have individual male flowers and individual female flowers. Here you can see right here what a male flower looks like. It is a single standalone flower that contains all of the pollen. Then, right next to it, we have a female flower. As you can see, the female flower has a little baby cucumber attached to it, and then there is the flower on the end of that little baby cucumber. That's how you can tell the difference between a male and female flower on a cucurbit. The female flowers have the baby fruit attached. And this holds true for all other cucurbits. Female zucchini flowers have a tiny zucchini attached, female watermelon flowers have a tiny watermelon attached, etc. In order to pollinate this female flower, a bee must fly from the male flower to the female flower and manually transfer the pollen. It has to manually go from here to here. And if that doesn't happen, this baby cucumber right here will abort. It will turn yellow, shrivel up, and fall off. If you're experiencing this, it's because your female flowers are not being pollinated. And again, this holds true for every other cucurbit like squash, zucchini, watermelons, pumpkins, and gourds. This is very common in areas with low bee activity, so if your garden isn't swarming with bumblebees, expect cucumber production problems. Now, alternatively, you can manually hand pollinate your flowers. You can take a blush brush like this or a mascara brush, and you can dip it into the male pollen inside the male flowers and then manually pollinate the female end of the flower. And if you do that at the right time before the female fruit begins to shrivel up and abort, it will hold its fruit and it will bring the cucumber to maturity. However, if this sounds like too much work, I have some good news. There is an easier way. On last summer's cucumber video, I turned you onto an amazing variety of cucumber called Bait Alpha. This variety was special because it is parthenocarpic. Parthenocarpic means that the female fruit will persist on the plant without pollination. This is totally different than self-fertile. Self-fertile simply means that a single plant can pollinate itself, but if pollination fails, which is common on cucumbers, the female fruit will drop. Self-fertility is the condition of most cucurbits, which are monoecious plants, which means self-fertile, producing both male and female flowers, but they still require pollination between the flowers to hold the fruit. Parthenocarpa cucumbers like Bait Alpha will hold many of their fruits despite no pollination at all. In fact, if you pinch off the male flowers on this plant and you ensure that there is no cross-pollination from the male flowers on other cucumber varieties, this variety will produce completely seedless female fruit. These can be grown in greenhouse environments where there are no pollinators and you don't have to hand pollinate them. The occasional fruit will still drop here and there, but most will persist on the vine, dramatically increasing your fruit. This plant is only about a month old and it is just loaded with fruit. There's fruits all over this plant, as you can clearly see, and this plant here is just a baby. While I love the Bait Alpha variety, I wanted to dig around and find other special Parthenocarpic varieties to trial, and I'm happy to announce that I struck gold with another variety, and that variety is China Jade right here. China Jade is an ancient Chinese cucumber believed to trace as far back as the Han Dynasty. The reason why I love this cucumber is that it is also Parthenocarpic and can hold its fruits without pollination, but it's very different than Bait Alpha. Bait Alpha is a Persian-style cucumber. It's very smooth, crisp, and mild. China Jade, on the other hand, is stronger flavored, and it's more beefy and meaty. The cucumbers are also potentially enormous. The cucumbers can grow up to a yard long if you let them continue to grow, although I will warn you, they will start getting very tough when you let them get that size. They're much better tasting when you harvest them young and crisp, similar to this one right here. You can maybe let them get just a little bit larger than that. When they're young like that, they are delectably crisp. If I had to choose, I think I enjoy the Bait Alpha a little more, but these are also delicious, and they do have one big advantage over Bait Alpha. And that advantage is China Jade is freakishly disease resistant. These right here are my two original China Jade plants that I started from seed around April 1st. My climate is brutally hot and humid. The heat index the past few days has been over 120 degrees here, which will destroy most varieties of cucumbers. Still, this variety is thriving and it is pumping out fruit. I mean, just look at this monster cucumber over here. By comparison, my original Bait Alpha plants, which I planted right here at the same time that I planted those two China Jade plants that I just showed you, are effectively dust. Look at them. There's barely anything left. Now, I consider this Bait Alpha variety to be disease resistant, but every plant has limits. The China Jade variety is just nothing short of freakish, and I think that's because it's a Chinese variety, and China tends to be even more humid than the United States at the same latitude, so it appears to have extreme humidity tolerance and disease resistance. And the final tip that I want to give you is this. When growing cucumbers, you must harvest them early and often. Once a cucumber plant matures one fruit, it will then begin to signal to itself that it reproduced successfully and it's now time to die back. Never let your cucumbers turn yellow on the vine, because if they do, that tells the plant that it succeeded at producing mature, fertile seed and it's time to die. The way you have crazy cucumber harvests is to pick the cucumbers when they're young and crisp. This will signal to the plant that it needs to fruit more and more because it's running out of time to produce seed before the season ends. Just make sure you feed the plant enough fertilizer in the process. Cucumbers are ravenous feeders when they're producing heavily, so fertilize about every 7 to 10 days with a couple handfuls of an organic 555 fertilizer and a drink of something soluble like organic Alaska fish emulsion, and then mix into that something like Miracle-Gro tomato or Miracle-Gro bloom booster, or if you want to keep it completely organic, you can use an organic soluble bloom booster like Alaska Moor Bloom. This will help keep the production going later into the season. I also recommend that you succession plant your cucumbers. They have a short lifespan, so it's a good idea to place a fresh crop of cucumbers into the ground every 4 to 6 weeks or so throughout the season. Don't fight and struggle trying to keep one cucumber plant alive throughout the year. This is my, right here, this is my second crop. This is also part of my second crop. So this is my second planting of the year. And in another couple of days, I'm probably going to start a third crop because these will be worn out long before my growing season comes to an end. So now let's pick some. So like I said, you definitely want to make sure that you harvest your cucumbers early and often. So let's pick a few of each variety and then we'll take them inside and we'll try them out.
And here's our harvest. Here we have the Bait Alpha cucumbers. You can see they're the smaller Persian types. And here you can see the China Jade very long cucumbers. They're very, very different. And I just want to show you a cross section of the interior. I don't want to cut these completely in half because I'm not going to be able to eat all of that tonight. So let's first start with the Bait Alpha. And it does look like I did get a couple of seeds in here. You can see that most of the seed cavity is hollow, but I do have a few seeds here and there. So obviously there was a little bit of either self-pollination or cross-pollination. Like I said, if you get rid of those male flowers, then you're not going to have any seeds at all. But you can kind of see the cavity in there. There are a small amount of seeds, but it's next to nothing compared to most cucumbers. And I want you to hear just how crunchy the Bait Alpha is. It's like eating a Dorito, except it's a whole lot healthier. Now we're going to cut into this monster China Jade. And this is off of my older plant that I planted way back in April. And look at this. That older plant was kind of off by itself because my other Bait Alpha died back and my new plantings were pretty far away on the opposite side of the garden. This one is completely seedless. This whole seed cavity right here does not have anything in it. There's no seeds in there at all. It is completely hollow, so that is pretty cool. That is pretty cool, especially if you hate cucumber seeds. Now let's see what the taste of this is like. Also very crispy. I will say that the Bait Alpha is a lot sweeter than the China Jade. And it's funny to call a cucumber sweet, but the Bait Alpha is literally sweet. This cucumber right here is just, it's like a standard cucumber. It's very crisp and it's very refreshing, very delicious. And it wouldn't be any kind of taste testing video without getting the official taste tester involved. Dale, why don't you try the cucumber? Oh, Dale, no, come here, come back. He stole the cucumber, that little booger. Dale, I have another one over here. Oh man, I think he thinks it's a chew toy. He's treating it like it's his deer jerky. Well, I was able to coax him back here, but Dale, you have to give the people a taste review. You can't just run off like that. Now, Dale, stay. Try this one. No, Dale, stay. Ah! And he's gone again. Dale, give us a taste review. Dale, tell us what you think. I guess it's good. And that right there are two incredible cucumber varieties that have really changed the way that I grow cucumbers. They've made life so much easier and I've never had better yields, and they are both absolutely delicious and I cannot recommend them enough to all of you, regardless of what your growing season is like, how long or how short. They will do well in pretty much all climates and conditions. So everybody, I sure hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please make sure to hit that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please subscribe for future updates and more videos like these. If you're curious about any of the gardening products that I use, they are all linked down in the Amazon storefront link in the video description. If you're curious about purchasing any merchandise and supporting the channel, I have that all linked in my Spreadshop down in the video description as well. They're all custom-made designs. Thank you all again so much for watching, and I hope to see all of you again on the next video.